guys, welcome to the 2017 Body Transformation Challenge. We're going to give you a few tips and pointers about how to effectively and efficiently grow free shop. Joel's got a couple rules to follow for you.
I think rule number one should always be coming with a plan. You should know exactly what you need, how much of it you need, anything like that. And the second rule should definitely be not to shop when you're hungry.
The third rule would be to always start on the perimeter of the grocery store. Most of your whole foods are found on the outside, so do your grocery shopping on the outside of the grocery store before you hit any of the aisles. We're going to talk about our healthy carbs. Any fruit falls into that category, sweet potatoes, quinoa, brown rice, and there's a couple to use in moderation. So we can look at our healthy carbs and we can decide how can we effectively shop on a budget if some of us are on a budget. The other thing is do you shop organic or not? If you have the means to do it, great. If you don't, do your best with whole foods, and we can talk about what are the really important products to buy organic versus not if you have that option. As far as your cup of healthy greens or healthy veggies, you can use any of the greens you'll find in the lettuce section. I would recommend sticking with more of a kale, a spinach, a mixed green. Not always iceberg lettuce. If you can help it, it's good to get nutrition as well as the greens.
I think when you are choosing fruits and veggies, it's important to do like rainbow selected fruits. The different colors means that there's different vitamins, nutrients, minerals. You're not getting the same thing that's in different greens as you are with some of the yellows, reds, oranges, and some of the other fruits and veggies too. We're talking about meats, it's good to try and get 2 servings of seafood per week just because it has the healthy omega fats when you're doing it. When you're eating fish, salmon is usually a good choice to get to because it's not super fishy and it's pretty good tasting for those who aren't big on the seafood taste.
And we're going to focus on skipping the breaded fish. Head to something that's non-breaded. Frozen is okay. If you can afford fresh, shipped in daily, this would be what I would recommend. When you're choosing your other meats, there's a percentage as to which we ask you to get lean meats for now. So if you're gonna go, chicken breast is a good one. You can go with turkey breast, or you can take it off an actual turkey, but this is just the turkey breast. If you're gonna go ground turkey, try and go like 93% lean is really awesome. And then if you're gonna do ground beef, just look for the leaner one, like this is 91% lean. Or if you're gonna do a steak, just make sure it's the lean version. The last thing is pork is on there for moderation. For all you bacon lovers, just eat pork to like once a week, you can have it. Another thing you want to take into consideration when you're looking for meats is you want fresh meats with non-preservatives. And a lot of times if we look at our lunch meats or our sausages, there's a lot of preservatives in them. We recommend staying away from those for the most part. If you come into a bind and you're gonna grab a sugary snack or like some turkey, I'd rather have you grab some turkey. However, because there's a lot of nitrates in there, we prefer you stay away from those for right now.
Along the lines of preservatives, it's typically good to get stuff that has less than 5 ingredients. If your food has more than 5 ingredients, it's not very natural, and as Carla was saying, there's gonna be a lot of artificial things in it.
For most of you, in your application, you said that you do okay with eggs, so that'll be part of our challenge. So as far as eggs goes with us, large eggs are just fine. We're gonna do a lot of egg whites. So if you prefer to actually just get egg whites, as long as there's not preservatives in the egg whites, the carton that you choose, that's thumbs up as well.
Fruit juices are another form or another added sugar into the diet, and we're really trying to limit the added sugar that you have. So if you do fruit juices, make sure none of them are from concentrate. It's 100% natural.
It says it's 100% orange juice, but it's from concentrate.
Yep.
So you have to look at that.
Gotta look for the little writing right there and make sure there's no added sugar there. If you have kids, I know that cartoons are targeted for kids, but usually when they have cartoons, they are full of sugars, full of ingredients that you don't need. So typically just try and avoid anything with cartoons on them.
For instance, Pop-Tarts, for one Pop-Tart upwards to 20 grams of sugar. The recommended daily allowance for men is 36 and for women is 24. That's for a grown adult. Most kids have two when they have these, and they have fruit juice. So they are well over your recommended daily allowance, if not doubled by that point.
Sugars in Fruity Pebbles, 14 grams. Lucky Charms, 12. Frosted Flakes, 12. So a lot of these are not all that great of an option.
And that's 3/4 of a cup. So chances are you eat double that. The other thing, Scooby-Doo's, there's 10 grams in one of those. Let's see here. Captain Crunch, 9 grams, but you probably have 18 because you double it. Some of the things that you think are healthy, that are marketed as healthy, like Raisin Bran. Raisin Bran for a 1 cup serving, which most people have more than that, is 18 grams of sugar. That's a lot. And you, by the way, you add milk, and that will add on another 8 to 10.
Special K, only 4, but chances are you probably don't. A lot of things like this are meal replacement or targeted as healthy. You look at it, and we're looking at as prepared with how they tell you to make it. That's 31 grams of sugar in there. So probably not that good of an option.